What's up, guys? Right now my Instagram is either like super glossy, high editorial kind of Y2K edits, or it's super casual with literally no filter on it. I'm gonna show you how to do that. I am not a graphic designer, so if I can do it, so can you. Let's get started. I'm gonna show you how to edit three photos. The first one is like the quintessential Y2K moment. It's got stickers on it, crazy wallpaper. I even have a like legit 2000s MacBook computer. And this one just screams like Y2K, Chromatica, Xenon Z3. The second one, I think, looks like it just came out of a catalog, like Adelia's catalog. And the third one is a great example of when you do a shoot and you have so many different photos that you like, but you obviously don't want to post all of them, like six photos on Instagram. So this is a great way to kind of stack and layer yourself into a room that you don't necessarily have. It'll make sense when we get to it. The photos that I'm showing you, I did shoot in front of a backdrop because it's easier to cut, but you can absolutely do it from any photo that's already existing, or if you take one now and there's like stuff behind you. I have a few examples in which I just cut myself out of like a normal photo that I wasn't even anticipating editing. It is possible, it's just a little bit more difficult, but all of the backgrounds that I find are on Pinterest, and that's where I find a lot of this inspiration. What I kind of do is if I find a background on Pinterest that I really like, I'll try to work backwards and choose an outfit that would complement it. Or if I have an outfit that I already shot or I wanna shoot, then I'll look up on Pinterest like more keywords with the colors involved to find that backdrop, background. For this first photo, we're gonna start in Facetune 2 app. I love this app for giving you this like glossy editorial moment. There's so many things that you can do in this app. I'm gonna show you just like the few things in particular. So I go into retouch, and I whiten my teeth if I need any whitening. I smooth out any fine lines and wrinkles. And then I go into details and I kind of like touching up my eyes and hair just to make them pop a little bit more. And then the last thing that I'll do is hit glow, and this will help bring back any highlight that may have gotten taken away from the smoothing tool. And then what I do is I go into defocus, and I'm blurring out the background so that it's easier for me to cut it out in the third app that I'm gonna show you. Yes, three apps. It's fun, it's necessary. I'll walk you through it. And then I wanted to show you guys that you can actually add backdrops within this app. They do have that as an option. I just don't think it's as precise as the app that I'm gonna show you, but you really just take your finger across and it'll automatically recognize your body. So it won't go over all of it, but sometimes like a knee or an arm might accidentally get marked over. So you just wanna zoom in and erase that section. There's also a ton of different backdrops that you can choose from, but I don't, again, particularly love using the backdrop option in Facetune app. Just wanna show you it was there. Okay, so once I'm happy with my little edits, I take the photo into the next app, Prequel. This app is awesome. I could be in this app for hours because there are so many filters and effects that you can do. It's actually so fun, and you could also do it with some video effects. This one is a really popular app, so if you're trying to find like a cool effect that a lot of people are doing, it's usually in this app already, which is perfect if you are not a graphic designer like myself. Anyway, the filter Foxy and the third option in that one has been the one that I've been using, and I've been going to like 28 or 27 on the filter level. I just really like how this filter pulls the colors, and then I'm done in this app. And then I take it into PixArt, and this is, love PixArt. I can't use Photoshop. I like can finesse PicMonkey if I try hard enough, but girlfriend, this is the best app ever. It is so user-friendly, and I absolutely recommend it. This is how people are doing, I mean, how I feel most people are doing these kind of edits. So what you're gonna do for this one is you're going to pull the backdrop that you've chosen on Pinterest or whatever site you're using, and you're going to go into add photo once you've added the backdrop, and go ahead and add that photo that you wanna cut out. And at the bottom, there's an option for cutout. You're gonna hit that, and sometimes it'll automatically cut yourself for you and make the background transparent, or you can hit person and that'll also automatically cut you out. I usually go over again with restore and just go over any parts of my body that weren't selected automatically. Hit save and you'll see that you've been cut out now and you're transparent essentially. So you want to zoom in, hit erase, and start kind of outlining what was missed in the background that wasn't like completely erased. This can be a little bit tedious. I recommend just taking your time with this one. You could resize the eraser tool and get to work. Once you're satisfied with everything that's been erased behind you, make sure that you love the placement of your image, because as soon as you hit apply, there is no going back. You'll have to start it all over again if you accidentally put it in a different place and then hit apply. You cannot change it. So make sure that you love the placement and hit apply. So the next thing that I did was I wanted to put a photo of myself in the computer. So I'm going into add photo at the bottom and I'm adding that second photo of me that I want to overlay in the computer. And what I'm doing is resizing that image and placing it over the screen. And if you hit opacity when you've selected that image, it makes it a little bit easier to find where you can then erase like the outside so that I'm not accidentally erasing too much. And then I'm happy with that edit. I bring the opacity back up so that you can actually see the photo again and apply it in the computer. And that's it for that. I could choose to be done here, but I think what would be really fun is to go full Y2K. I go into the stickers and I'm just looking up some Y2K like cyber stuff. This angel thing is really cute, so I'm putting that in. And then also a little heart. And that is our photo. I love it. It's so cute. I love this one. Now that you have the foundation there, you can really just do anything you want. So I'm gonna show you how I did this kind of Delia's moment. That's kind of how I'm categorizing it. I had this hat. It's actually the visor that I'm wearing is from Limited 2. I literally got it in the early 2000s. So I brought them in the Pixar and I really wanted to get this like crumpled paper texture. I got that wallpaper off of Pinterest. Anyway, so I cut out the first image over top of the paper and then I pulled the second one at the same time just so that it's easier to edit. And this is where I messed up, okay? So I was like cutting it all out and everything. But I accidentally applied the sticker, not knowing that I would also apply the second one that I added. So I accidentally like left myself on my shoulder. And the way that I found the solution instead of having to redo all of it was I just pulled the paper piece again and placed it over the image of myself that I wasn't able to cut out and went ahead and overlaid it and erased like whatever leftover parts were on my arm, if that makes sense. Then I went ahead and added that photo back in and cut myself out. This one was so tedious because I feel like if it looks shitty, like if you do a shitty job of outlining yourself, it's gonna look really amateur, and it definitely looks amateur because I am an amateur. So I tried really hard to make it look good, but this was definitely one of those moments where like if I messed up and it wasn't really great or precise, you could definitely see it. So I'm calling myself out, okay? And then I really wanted to pull in the entire like cherry that's on the visor. And so I looked up cherry in the stickers, found this cherry bomb one and thought that was just so perfect. And I love this photo. I love the eyeshadow. I really outdid myself here. This last one, I call this one, it's not your house, but it could be, because this is another example of what you could do if you have like a particular color in your outfit, or that's kind of where I went with this one. I was like, oh, this purple is gorgeous. I want to find something that's like not my house, but it could look like it's my house, or like I want it to be my house, and also showcase a bunch of photos because I think I look really good in this picture. That was my thought process. So I just looked on Pinterest and I found this really cool retro bathroom. I don't even know if it's actually a real place. And it was a very similar process. I went into PixArt after I edited all the photos that I wanted and I selected multiple at the same time. And I just went through and cut out the background for each photo. And before applying, I went in and kind of like rearranged all the pictures to make sure that I liked where they were on the page. And this is what I came up with. So that's how I edit these Y2K photos. There's so many things that you can do with them. Really, the possibilities are endless. If you guys wanna see me do another video where I walk you through how I edit some of them, let me know. If you guys want more like daily updates and seeing kind of more fashion and video editing and photo editing in the moment, feel free to check me out on TikTok and Instagram and give me a follow. And don't forget to like this video and subscribe if you like this one. That would be awesome. That's it for me. Yeah, I'll see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching. Bye.